We have always been uncomfortable with the fact that home monitoring has gone from a program that was almost exclusively for drug offenders and low-level offenders to a program that has the majority of the people in the program are gun offenders. That's something that I've always said is not what the program is for. So we revamped the program to put GPS on it. So it's made it better. It's much better. It's much better for us as far as trying to locate people, much better for us to know when there's a legitimate concern that someone's left the house. The old devices had a lot of false positives and a lot of ways to really play with the machine. So it's made it better, and I cannot emphasize enough, the University of Chicago's free assistance for about 2 years now has taken this up quite a few notches too. So it's made the program much better, much more secure than it's ever been, but I still have that complaint, which is that there's certain people that I don't believe should be on home monitoring, no matter what device you use. Prior to COVID hitting, we had already seen a dramatic change in the type of people that were being put on home monitoring by the judges. I'd voiced my objection to it, but they were keep putting them out. I tried not to put them out, and I was sued by the Public Defender's Office, I think, and some other entity to force me to put people out. So we put people out. But so prior to COVID, we were getting a change where all of a sudden now a program meant for nonviolent offenders was being used for violent offenders. 30 to 40 people charged with murder, numerous people charged with attempt murder, our largest group of people charged with unlawful use of weapon. So that was happening before, but then when COVID hit, the hard number of people being put out on the program increased by almost 1,000 people. And when you're the one dealing with it, sometimes it's hard to fully appreciate the magnitude of it, but there isn't even a close second in the entire country as far as utilizing home monitoring than in Cook County. We've always had the largest number of them, but they were always the largest number of nonviolent people, which was a good thing. They didn't belong in jail, but there was a concern about something, so a device was put on. Now there's a different level of people being put on there, which requires, minimum, you have to have GPS so that you can have a higher level of security, which it provides us. And then when you add the benefits from the University of Chicago's help, we have a better understanding of where the crime's occurring, where people are who are on EM, and so it's been another layer of help as well. People had asked me, why were you not using GPS 10 years ago? And I explained to them two things. One was the people we had on home monitoring were minor drug offenders, retail thieves, things like that, that frankly, if they left their house, they most likely were going to get more drugs that I'm not in favor of, but they weren't going to harm anyone. And so we didn't need this higher level of technology. But the other part of it, at that point in time, the GPS devices, the band on them was almost identical to the other one. And so literally, I explained to people, I go, so I will pay the extra money to get GPS for this person charged with a drug offense so that when he cuts the device off, I know where I can go to find the device. I go, it doesn't seem to me a good use of anything, because anybody who went on the run back then was cutting their device off, and GPS wasn't going to do anything other than help me get the device back. So the new device, though, is, I don't say anything's impossible in this world, but to get it off is really, really difficult. And so that will help us a great deal on our AWOLs. And our AWOLs, by and large, I'd say about half of them almost, are within a window of like 6 months. What that means is that we have a unit that goes out looking for them and all that, but we usually find them. And there's sort of a turnover where they're gone for a month, we'll find them, they pick up a new case, whatever it might be, we'll bring them in. But it's there is like that group of like 200, and then there's about 100 people who've been missing for over a decade, 15, 20 years.